Well, not all racism is crude, rude and shocking. There is also casual racism. It's subtle and sometimes not even intended to be hurtful. We're going to chat with someone who can tell us firsthand the damage it can do. We'll meet Robbie shortly, but first, here's some of his story.
You're not staying there, right?
The brutal sting of racial discrimination can cause deep physical and emotional scars. From suspicious looks from people behind shop counters...
What do you think she's up to?
..right through to the vicious verbal attacks. 27-year-old Robbie McGuinness is someone all too familiar with discrimination. Robbie believes he's singled out because he's an Indigenous Australian. And while a remark or a joke can seemingly be said without consequence, for Robbie and thousands more like him, those comments can be life-threatening.
All these little things just piling on top of another, it just really took its toll to the point that I actually tried to take my life several times.
Thankfully, he recovered, but just as he was beginning to deal with depression and anxiety, there were more challenges on the horizon. He discovered he was bisexual, and so the homophobic slurs joined the racial taunts. He quickly fell back into a deep depression.
Being called black dog, I thought that was bad, but then being called, you know, like a black panther or something is just like, it was a whole new low and just sent me back to square one. Tried to kill myself again. Couldn't take it because everything was piling on again. I was drinking more.
Like so many people, Robbie tried his best to hide what he was going through from his family.
Lying to my mum and my family, just with the depression, not being as open with them, trying to take everything all on by myself.
Stay with us after the break. We're going to talk to Robbie. It's a conversation we definitely need to have right around Australia. You're watching Studio 10. Welcome back. Well, whether we want to admit it or not, racism is a real problem in this country, and sometimes it's not even intended to be hurtful. Now, before the break, we heard some of Robbie's story, and he's with us on the couch now. G'day, Robbie.
Hey, how are you?
Thanks for joining us. Before the break, we saw your story and we heard that some of the things that you've been called, a black dog, which is absolutely abhorrent. What other racism have you endured? What other things have you come up against?
So a lot of it's subtle racism. Walking into a shop is probably, that was more about 10 years ago when you're a teenager. You're walking in a shop and they automatically just jump on you.
How do you mean jump on you?
Like, the student, you walk into the shop and it's not even 10 seconds later and they're like, oh, can I help you with something? And
they're
it's
just suspicious like, of you.
Yeah, and it's like, I haven't even had a chance to look at something. Mm. And you can kind of feel the difference in the tone of their voice, whether they're being really good at customer service or whether they're suspicious. And because, you know, you'll probably walk into a casual store or something and, because we used to go to school across the road from a shopping centre. So we'd probably being trackies or whatever, and it's just, you know, like, it's like, oh, like that pretty woman, like, oh, you can't afford this, yeah. Like, kind of thing. And it's just like, well, you probably can't afford it either, because you're working in an expensive store.
Is
like,
that
it's
kind
just
of
like,
racism harder to endure than, say, somebody calling you a name?
Oh, for me, definitely. I think if it's more direct, you can deal with it and take it on and go, okay, well, that person's just ignorant and uneducated and they don't know what they're talking about, obviously. Or they might be having trouble in their own lives or whatever and just and venting. But when it's so subtle and it's just like looks that you get, I think that's a little bit harder to deal with because you start thinking about your insecurities and it's like, oh, is it because of the colour of my skin? Is it because of the way that I look?
There's an incredible campaign that's running on television at the moment, in fact, that shows, particularly on a bus, someone is sitting on the bus and, he won't sit next to the Indigenous man.
Yeah.
You know, you actually said that this campaign's had quite a lot of negative feedback as well.
There was on Facebook, it's the greatest platform for any negative or venting thing, as well as positive stuff. But, there was a lot of negative feedback, some people saying get over it,
Did that surprise you, that volume of negative feedback? Were you anticipating that?
No. It did surprise me. In this day and age, like, we're in, 2014, that there is that negative thing. And I'm not saying that Aboriginal people are the only ones that cop racism. Everyone cops racism. It's something that we've got to try and... what's the word?
Like, be aware of and stand out.
Yeah.
Get rid of. But what's the emotional toll like to have to endure this day in, day out? What does it do to you?
It was more back in the day, you know, when I was younger, and it's like you got your
school
life.
You're not very old now.
I'm 10 years older than I was when I was going through it. So,
this is the ad, yeah.
Yeah, Greg, I knew quite a lot of them actors. They're all friends of mine and things. So I think that campaign with Beyond Blue is actually amazing. Stop, think, respect. I think everyone needs to just, you know, stop, have a look at themselves, think about it and respect, because I don't want to name anybody. So the comments that I came about was, get over it, we raped your women, we killed your children, rah, rah. Ugh. And I was just like, you do have a mother and possibly a sister. If that happened to you, would you be saying the same thing? Mm. How would you feel if someone else was saying it to you? It's just, you know, everyone's got a mum. Mm. So for anyone to even say that is just... I don't know.
It's unacceptable.
Exactly. And it's just like I actually want to reach out to people like that and be like, you know, what's going on in your life to make you this angry? Like, talking about it's the best thing.
Stop, think, respect.
Yes.
Pretty easy, isn't it?
Yes.
All right, Robbie, thank you very much for sharing your story. We do wish you all the best.
Thank you.